sophisticated side.
Uh-oh, I'm on the wrong
can
side.
Can you read that God didn't bring you this far?
God didn't bring you this far.
To leave you now.
To leave you now.
Now, let's see if I get some help on this side. God didn't bring you this far.
God didn't bring you this far.
To leave you now.
To leave you now.
Amen.
There is nothing to be compared.
Yes, sir.
With a relationship with God.
Amen.
I mean a one-on-one relationship. One that you have so close with God that you know that he's going to be there for the good time and the bad time. You have no shadow of doubt. You don't know when. You don't know where. But you just know that God going to make a way for you.
Amen.
Have you ever been to the point where you didn't know what to do? I mean a close relationship. One that beyond imagination. One that's so defined that it defined human logic. They don't know how you did it.
Yes.
They don't understand where you came from and how you got the job done, but God did.
Right.
I mean a divine relationship.
Yes.
They said you couldn't do it. They said you wasn't going nowhere. But when you know that you know that you know. Jonah was a special lad.
Special.
God had did something unique in his life.
Yeah.
It's been proven time and time again where there is no vision, the people will fail. Don't be so quick to blame your pastor. Because you ought to have a vision in your home.
Yeah.
You ought to have a vision over your children.
Yeah.
But if we look around in our church, we're getting old.
Yeah.
We're getting slower.
Uh-huh.
Then that means we need to go out and start investing our time and money into our young folks.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. God gave me a plan a long time ago that if you start investing in these children, that after a while it will pay off.
Yeah.
I thought about it. I could have went out and hired a professional musician.
Yeah.
I could have went out and paid somebody else to come in and play every Sunday. But I looked out among the folk and saw some of the smart young kids.
Yeah.
And I told the parent, if you put them in school, I will pay for them to go to music school.
Yeah.
I know I'm not going to get no amen. Y'all want me to go preach on sin, this and sin, that I get to sin after a while. But if you will start taking and investing back into the young folks,
amen,
it'll bear fruition after a while.
Amen.
Now, let me tell you something now. That was some. I had about three in school at one time. All of them not going to work out. But at least you give them the opportunity.
Yeah.
I told the young lady now that you're going to see as a waitress around the church and in the kitchen. And smart young lady. And I told her fella about 2 years ago, go ahead on and put her in music school and I'll pay. And all kind of excuses and all kind of. You know what? If you want to produce extraordinary children and productive children, you got to spend some quality time with that child. Every time this old man rocked in the rocking chair, this dog would start hollering and crying.
Yeah.
So finally, the young man walked over and asked, "Old man, I want to ask you a question." He said, "What is it, son?" He said, "Is you rocking back on that dog tail?" He said, "No." He said, "Why is he hollering then?" He said, "Right in that spot where he's laying, there's a nail sticking up through the plank." He said, "When will he move then?" He said, "Well, he ain't hurt bad enough. When he hurt bad enough, he'll get up and move to another spot." You can preach all you want. You can preach till you fall dead. But until you folk get tired and sick and tired, God don't have mercy. They ain't going to move to another spot. I had a 3-day revival, the old high tower came down.
Yeah.
And he would tell you that the mega church came over and put on a program, and over 1,000 and some folks showed up for the 3-day revival.
Yeah.
They came in wheelchairs, they came and brought the field, they came all kind of. turned away. And they came because of all the free prizes and the free gift that the church was giving away. Y'all ain't going to say nothing. And I told y'all, Hightower, if I get 20 folks out this crowd, I'll be satisfied. Yeah. If the preacher doesn't revive us, I'm believing God for 100. Lord have mercy. Yeah. But you know what I found out about life? We don't fail because we aim too high. Most people fail because they aiming too low. Yeah. Y'all ain't going to say nothing. Yeah. Then after the revival was over with, on that spotting Sunday, you got to well guess how many came back. Zero. Y'all ain't going to talk to me. You can pull all kind of giving, put on all kind of programs, but unless the Lord get down in that hole, people are not hungry and thirsty that were watching it like they used to thirst. Jacob had, he had had an encounter with God. He said, I'm not going to let go till you bless me. Till you bless me. Then they only have another dream. He dreamed out a loud reaching from heaven to the earth. And he saw angels descending and ascending up to the Most High. And Jacob said, when I saw, looked at the top of the ladder, I saw God sitting up there. Lord, my God, I am the God of Abraham. I am the God of Isaac. And he looked down at the land and said, all the land that you see will be given unto your seed. You got to invest into your seed. Well, there was no doubt in their mind. They knew what the dream meant. They understood that God worked and moved through dreams. And they made up their mind that they were going to throw it in the pit. Yes, nobody can stop your dream. The devil can't block it. And people sure can't stop it. He was always telling the other, telling his daddy about the evil doing of his brother. And he had a close relationship with his father. Nobody can separate you from the love of God. You have to make up your mind from hell or high water. I let nothing separate me from the love of God. Some of you went through hell and everything. Raise your children by yourself. Work your finger on. And now you want to give up on God. Good God, my. Yes. They tell me. They made up in their mind. Shoulder. But you got to go through on your get to in the beginning and in the end. The trouble in the middle, good God Almighty, you tell me. Gonna come in the pit. You gonna be hurt in the pit. You gonna have to cry sometime in the pit. You'll be wounded. Good God Almighty, tell me down in the pit. Y'all ain't never been there. You've been left alone. You never call on him.
Sold that stuff, and now he got a reason.